How's it going, everyone? My name is Michael SK, and welcome back to Steins Gate Linear Bounded Phenogram. In the last episode, Mayuri decided, I'm gonna do what everybody else has been doing, and leap through time. I don't know what her reasoning is. I don't know if that was touched upon. I think she's trying to do whatever she can to not be a burden and help out in, well, saving herself, which is what Okabe has been trying to do for her. Without her knowledge, obviously. So, now we're at Kitchen Jiro, however you pronounce it. I don't know why. I feel like I'm missing something, but whatever, let's continue on. We had to wait in line for a while and then finally got seated at the counter. As soon as we're settled in, we order our usual without even looking at the menu. I'm having menchi katsu rice. Okunin is having curry with two pieces of menchi katsu as toppings. He calls his concoction Mad Menchi Katsu Curry. Seeing that our favorite orders haven't changed makes me really happy.
Mayuri, yake ni niyakete iru ga, doushita? Kyou wa nanda ka itsu ni mo mashite hen da zo.
Oh, that's right. Okabe is now Mayuri's hostage.
Nanda ka koushite Okarin to issho ni itsumo no menu o matteru no wa shiyawase da na tte shimijimi omotte itan da.
1000 yen de otsuri ga kuru shiyawase ka. Mayuri wa jitsu ni tegaru de ii na.
Juicy karaage number 1 to ka banana to ka karaage age kun de mo 十分幸せだけどね.
Three simple foods, that's really it.
ますます安いな.
We were awkward with each other before coming to Kitchen Jiro, but we're at our usual shop, getting our usual order. Our usual typical conversation feels so comfortable to me. Days like these make all the bad stuff seem like a dream. I feel like these never-changing days will continue tomorrow, the day after, and forever after that. After waiting a little while, the staff brings us trays with our plates on them. My tray has menchi katsu a little bigger than the palm of my hand, garnished with plenty of salad. It also comes with rice and pork miso soup, so there's a lot of food on that tray, alright. Okarin boasts, as though he made it himself. It feels like the usual Okarin is back, and that makes me really happy. Okarin has to be like this.
Itadakimasu!
I put my hands together and start by biting into the extra large menchi as usual. A lot of juice comes pouring out from inside the crispy fried menchi. The rich taste of meat and sweetness of onions fills my mouth. I always smile when eating tasty food. And that smile makes me feel better.
Yappari, Kitchen Jiro no menchi katsu wa kamisugi da ne. Mayushi no naka de King of Niku no za wa fudou da yo.
Umu, Mayuri yo. Sono iken ni wa hageshiku douii suru. Sekai no shinri da na.
I vehemently agree. You mean agree? Whatever. As always, Okunin pours three drops of soy sauce onto his menchi and then grins boldly.
Kurau ga ii. Gastronomy crush!
The next moment, Okarin starts stabbing the menchi katsu with his spoon and mixes it into the curry.
Ah! Okarin, mata gucha gucha ni shichatte. Mottai nai yo.
Kore zo, mad menchi katsu kare no mad taru yuen. Mad scientist taru mono, kore kurai no tabegata wa shinai to na. Bonjin to wa chigau no da yo, bonjin to wa.
メンチカツへの冒涜にしか見えないけどな。
何を言う。これこそが至高の食べ方なのだ。参りもいずれわかる時が来る。それまではその無難極まりない定番メニューで満足しているがいい。
After saying this, Okarin opens his mouth wide and stuffs his cheeks with menchikatsu, curry, and rice all mixed together.
Okarin wa mukashi kara kare wa sou yatte mazete taberu ha da yo ne.
Kodomo no koro kara maddo datta kara na.
I mean, I do a lot of things, or I guess work with food in a lot of ways that I've always done when I was younger. It's just what you're used to.
そうだったっけ?
Albeit maybe not as messy as what Okabe is doing here, but whatever. I remember the moment Okarin became a mad scientist. Oh yeah, it's flashback time. To sad times. It was a day with light rain. After my grandma died, I felt like there was a big hole in my heart, and then Okarin made me his hostage.He said that it seemed like I'd go off somewhere if he didn't. But because I'm his hostage, I'm not allowed to go anywhere.
Mayuri? 何をぼーっとしている?
好きあり!
Okarin, his cheeks still stuffed with menchikatsu curry, suddenly thrusts his spoon at my menchikatsu.
Ah! Mayushi no na no ni!
He stole a bite of my menchikatsu.
油断大敵だな。人質に隙を見せるなど。
いつもオカリンはそうなんだから。オカリンのメンチカツ泥棒。2枚もトッピングしているのに、なんでマヨシーのを取るの?
カレーまみれになったメンチカツもいいが、やはりメンチカツそのものの素朴な味も味わいたいだろう。
それじゃあね、マユシーにもオカリンの一口ちょうだい。
人の食べ方にケチをつけといて食べたがるのか?
うん、見た目はあれだけど、美味しいかもしれないし。
うまいに決まっている。そこまで言うなら食ってみろ。
オカリン uses his spoon to scoop up a bite of mad menchikatsu curry, and then extends it towards my mouth.It seems like something a couple would do, so I start to feel embarrassed. Even though I feel nothing when I do it for customers at Mei Kun Yan Yan.
あれ?おいしい!
だから何度もうまいと言っているだろうが、見た目のグロさに惑わされるなと。
カレーと混ぜちゃったら、メンチカツのサクサク感がなくなっちゃうって思ってたけど、そうでもないんだね。ちゃんとサクサクしてて美味しい。
うんむ。一度に好物を全部摂取することができて効率もいい。考え抜かれた究極のバランス食と言っても過言ではない。マッドサイエンティストにふさわしい晩餐だと思い知ったか。
Your text is kind of going over the nameplate there. As Okarin starts lecturing, he quietly moves his spoon and scoops up more curry.It's not exactly romantic, but I feel warmth deep in my chest when I think about how we just shared an indirect kiss. I share indirect kisses with the homies all the time, I don't feel anything. We kissed back when we were kids, but we were just playing around. Wait, when did this happen? All of a sudden, I remember that clear as day. Why did I forget it until now?
なんだか、あれだね。昔のことって、案外忘れてないものだね。
Yes.
Huh? なんだいきなり。
普段は忘れてたりもするけど、何かの拍子にひょっこり思い出すものだなって思って、ちょっと安心したかな。
一体何を思い出したんだ?
へへ、秘密だよ。
なんだそれ、もったいぶるな。
オカリンも覚えてるかな?
だからなんだ?
ほら、子供の頃、ふざけ合って、キスしちゃったの覚えてない?
Oh god, we just killed him. Okarin starts choking.
Gomen, Okarin! Daijoubu?
I rub his back and hand him a tissue and a glass of water. Okarin blows his nose into the tissue and then gulps down the water.
Nani o ikinari yuu ka to omoeba, sonna mukashi no koto wa wasureta!
Okadine's as bad as lying as ever, or at lying as ever, and I feel a giggle coming on.
Sokka, wasurechattan da. Zonnen da na.
Kore ijou menchikatsu o ubawaretaku naku ba, damatte sasato taberou.
Hai.
At Okadine's warning, I hurry to stuff my face with menchikatsu. Out of the corner of my eye, I see Okadine looking sour as he silently scoops at his curry. And I can't help but wish, if only this relaxed and carefree, happy time will continue forever. If I kept doing time leaps, it could. And that strong temptation pulls at my heart.
Hora, Mayuri. 手が止まっているぞ。
Oh, ごめんごめん。
But that's no good. Chris-chan told me that repeating the same time over and over is nothing more than escapism.I think she's right. No matter how much it might hurt, we have to move forward. I'm scared that things could change, but they need to change.
で、マユリ、俺はいつまで人質でいればいいんだ？
今日いっぱいまでかな？
どこか付き合ってほしいところでもあるのか？ネカフェとか？それともカラオケでオールでアニソン三昧とか？
今はそんな気分じゃないかな。
なら、なんで俺を人質なんかにしたんだ？
それは、その…
Yeah, I'm curious myself. Okarin suddenly asks me straight, and I'm lost for words. I immediately try copying Okarin's exaggerated speech.
ふぅはははマユシーの陰謀に協力してもらうためなのです。
God damn, I'm trying to drink. Is he suspicious? When I look at Okarin, he's pointing his index finger up and shaking his head side to side.
全くもって笑い方がなってないな。これほどまで頼りない悪人笑い聞いたことないぞ。マユリよ。真の悪人笑いとはこんな風に笑うのだ。ふぅ
Damn, he really just kept that one going. The other customers are startled by Okarin's sudden laughter. But Okarin pays no attention to his surroundings and keeps laughing his head off. At a glance, Okarin is no different from usual. However, it seems like empty cheer or like he's forcing himself.Okarin always hides his true feelings with the mad scientist mask. I'm sorry, Okarin. But please endure it just a little longer. After filling our bellies at Kichinjiro, we take a little walk around Akihabara, as usual. After that, we get on the Yamanote Line train. Our destination is Ikebukuro.
久々のメンチカツライスは絶品だったよ。
I'm pretty sure there's an advertisement for Steins Gate on one of these posters. I know there's like some Chaos Head shit in the background up top, but I'm pretty sure there's like a Steins Gate one over there on the left. And then of course you got all the fucking frogs.
うまかったな。
They don't really hide it. It's just right there.
美味しいものを食べるとなんだか元気が出てくるね。
そうだな。
でも、オカリン、本当におごってもらってよかったの？
たまにはな。今は俺がマユリの人質なのだし、マユリはいつもラボにバナナを貢いでいるだろう。
別にあれは貢いでいるわけじゃなくて、マユシーが食べたいから買ってきてるだけなのに、 オカリン実験に使っちゃうんだもん。
バナナごときでケチケチするな。
だってゲルバナとかブヨブヨで美味しくないし、バナナに対する冒涜だよ。もっと食べ物は大事にしなくちゃ。バナナが浮かばれないよ。
実験には犠牲がつきものだ。その犠牲によって偉大なる発明品が生まれたのだから、むしろ誇りに思うがいい。
マユシーはバナナを美味しくいただける方がいいけどな。
It was supposed to be the usual trivial chat, but Okunin turns gloomy at my words.
まあ、それもそうかもしれないな。
The jokey atmosphere had completely disappeared and been replaced by a serious one.
オカリン？
どうこうした好奇心は身を滅ぼすって言葉もあるくらいだ。
オカリン smiles cynically and looks at me like he's in pain.
どうせ滅ぼすなら本人を滅ぼせばいいのにな。それなら自業自得ってことでまだ納得がいく。だが、罪もない人間を巻き込んで滅ぼすなんてのは間違ってる。
There's torment in his eyes. Until Christian told me, I had no idea why Okunin would look at me like this once in a while. But now I know. Okunin blames himself because he changed the world line Mayushi's supposed to die.
だけどね、オカリン。マユシーは電話レンジちゃんの開発に夢中になっているオカリンを見てるのがとっても好きだったけどな。
そうだったのか。
うん、オカリン、ご飯食べるのも寝るのも忘れちゃうくらい没頭してたよね。見てるだけのマユシーにまでワクワクする気持ちが伝わってきた。マユシーはね、難しいことはさっぱりだけど、開発に夢中になってるオカリンのそばでコスを作りながら、オカリンと一緒に大発明をしている気分を味わってた。オカリンの度を越した好奇心はね、宝物だと思うよ。
マユリ。
Okunin's pained face softens just a little bit. But just at that moment, the train arrives at Ueno Station and the doors open, flooding the train with a huge number of people. A big backpack pushes against my back, and I'm basically thrown forwards into Okunin's chest.
Mayuri, 大丈夫か？
大丈夫。
あまり大丈夫そうじゃないが、小さいとこんな時いろいろ大変だな。息はできるか？
なんとか。
My face is planted against Okunin's belly and it's hard to breathe.
少しの間辛抱しろ。
Okunin is trying to shield me from the people around us.It's almost like he's embracing me. I'm stuck against Okunin's body and my face gets hot. The train finally starts moving again. Every time the train sways, my face is pressed into Okunin's chest. His scent gives me a sense of relief, but also makes my heart race. I start to panic, since if we're stuck this closely together, Okunin might feel my heart pounding.
Mayuri, 変なのがいたらすぐに言うんだぞ。うむ、マイリはぼーっとしてるから、いかにも痴漢のターゲットになりやすそうだしな。
もう、マユシーはぼーっとしているようで、意外にぼーっとしてなんかないんだからね。
さあ、それはどうだろうな。
もう、オカリンは意地悪ばっかり。
I puff up my cheeks and rest my head against Okunin's chest.
どうした？
どうもしないよ。
そうか。てっきり満腹になって眠くなったのかと。
もう違うもん。
Maybe not absent-minded on Mayuri's part, but definitely oblivious on Okabe's. It's really calming, yet my heart is pounding so hard, it feels like it'll turn inside out. I'm thankful for this packed train.
Okari. Arigato.
Hmm? 何がだ?
いろいろ、たくさん、なんとなく。
変なやつめ。
Despite his mocking, he strokes my head.
なんだ?
ううん。なんでもないよ。
Stroking my head is like a habit for Okarin, so it probably doesn't mean anything to him. But it's special to me.
忘れたくないよ、オカリン。
I tightly grip Okarin's coat. I don't know if he heard me or not, but Okarin silently continues to hold me close. That's enough to mysteriously calm my unease. It takes a little over 10 more minutes to reach Ikebukuro. The time limit is slowly, but surely approaching. What is like the over- Oh, okay, well here we are. When we reach Ikebukuro, we head to Grandma's grave. I thought of all kinds of places, but this was the only place that seemed right.
墓参りならこの間したばかりだろ。肝試しでもするつもりか。
ううん、肝なんて試さないよ。だってマユシーはお化けとか別に怖くないもん。
見た目によらず結構たくましいよな、マユリは。
えへへ、悪いお化けはちょっと怖いかもだけど、お化けのおばあちゃんなら大歓迎っていう意味なのです。
そうか、まあそうだよな。
ここはマユシーにとって特別な場所だから、たまにこうやって散歩しに来るの。静かだし、星が一番綺麗に見えるし、なんだかとっても落ち着くんだ。
なるほど。ここは差し詰め、マユリにとってのサンクチュアリといったところか。
サンチュ…うん、まあ、そんなものかな。
Yeah, just bet. It's best to just roll with it there.
本当はよくわかってないだろう。サンチュは、肉を巻く野菜のことだ。
バレちゃった?
まあいい。いつものことだ。それで、人質はどうすればいい?
ここ、マユシーの定位置なんだ。オカリンも座って。
I sit down on the round stone near Grandma's grave and then scoot over a bit to make room for Okarin to sit. He sits down next to me.I look up at the night sky and I see stars spread out across the whole thing.
ほら、オカリン、見て。星すごいよ。綺麗でしょ。
ああ。
やっぱり、ここから見る星が一番綺麗だな。
暗い方が星がよく見えるからな。
うん。でも、それだけじゃなくて、ここはマユシーにとって山中なんとかだからね。余計綺麗に見える気がするのかも。
サンクチュアリな。それはいわゆる脳内補正というやつだな。マユリはそういうの得意そうだよな。
うん。
The two of us sit side by side, silently staring up at the night skyLooking up at the starry sky when it's so quiet makes me feel like I'll be sucked into it. Time slowly passes by in silence.
いつもここに座ってね。空を眺めて、 いろんなことを考えてたの。
一時は毎日来てたな。
オカリンも来てくれてたね。
マユリは俺の人質だからな。見張っておく義務があっただけだ。
へへへ、その説は本当にお世話になりました。ううん、あの時だけじゃなくて、オカリンにはいっぱいいっぱいお世話してもらっちゃってる。ごめんね。
なぜ謝る？
だって迷惑かけちゃってるから。
お前一人の面倒を見るくらいどうってことはない。
オカリン、いつもそう言ってくれてたよね。マユシーはそんなオカリンに甘えてた。でもね、それじゃいけないかもとも思ってたんだよ。
マユリ、どうした？今日はなんだか変だぞ。何かあったのか？
何もないよ。
マユリは嘘が下手だな。
オカリンほどじゃないと思うけどな。
俺が嘘が下手？
うん、オカリンはいつも優しい嘘ばっかりマユシーについてくれてたでしょ。ちゃんとマユシーは分かってるよ。
さあ、何のことだ？全く思い当たる節などない。マユリの気のせいだろう。マユリは脳内補正が得意だからな。
Okanin feigns ignorance with a forced look of confusion, and I can't help but laugh.
もう、オカリンは昔から本当天の弱だよね。変わらないんだから。
悪かったな。そういう星のもとに生まれたんだから仕方ないだろう。
星のせいにしちゃダメだよ。
Yeah, don't mess with the stars. That's truly Mayuri's forte. Our conversation pauses, and we're surrounded by silence again. I look at the night sky again and search for the usual star. Among the gently twinkling stars, I quickly find the North Star Polaris, shining especially bright.
見つけた。
何をだ？
おばあちゃんが教えてくれた星。
Grandma taught me about the stars. With picture book in hand, she taught about the easiest to find star. All right, thanks, game. The easiest way to find stars when I was a child. Polaris is the first one my Yushi was able to find. I stand up as though drawn toward its radiance. I stretch up, reaching for Polaris. I've always been jealous of that star, never changing, always shining in the same place.I wish Grandma could have stayed with me forever, just like it has.
Stardust shake hand, か。マユリのその癖も変わらないな。
うん。あの星を掴めたらね。マユシーもずっと変わらずにいられる気がして。
With my hand still stretched towards Polaris,I reveal the secret that I haven't told anyone before.
あの星？
ポラリス。ずっと変わらずに同じ場所で輝く星。
変わらずにか。
うん。変わってしまうのはとても怖いから。おばあちゃんが死んじゃった後、マユシーの世界は何もかも変わっちゃったから。全部が灰色で何も感じなくなって。出口の見えない巨大迷路に迷い込んじゃったみたいで。
Looking back and remembering it makes my body tremble.
寂しくて、怖くて。
I have a hard time continuing. It's like my entire body refuses to let me say anything more. But I wrap my arms around myself to stop my trembling, excuse me, and manage to open my mouth to continue. This is something I need to tell Okarin, at the very least.
実はね、おばあちゃんが死んじゃった日、マユシーは一緒にお団子を作って食べようねって約束してたんだ。作り方を教えてくれるって。だけど、ちょうどその日、マユシーはお友達に誘われてお祭りに出かけちゃって、おばあちゃんとの約束を破っちゃった。
Oh, that's gonna add some guilt.
おばあちゃんとはいつでも会えるし、また明日でもいいねって。だけど、その明日は来なかったんだ。
そう、だったのか。
うん。おばあちゃん、急に体の具合が悪くなっちゃって。だけど、一人暮らしだったから、倒れたことに誰も気づかないまま。もしもあの時、マユシーがきちんと約束を守っていたら、おばあちゃんは死なずに済んだのかもしれないって。ものすごく後悔した。でも、誰にもそんなこと言えなかった。マユシーが、おばあちゃんを殺したんだって言われるのが怖くて。
そんなわけないだろう。
だけど、誰にも言えないままかもしれない。かもしれないって、そればかりが、頭の中をぐるぐるして、止まらなくて。気がついたら、マユシーを取り巻く世界が、灰色になっちゃってた。
防衛本能みたいなものだったんだろうな。
うん。でもね、その迷路から助け出してくれたのは、オカリンだったんだ。こっちが出口だよって教えてくれた。
あの時のマユリはどこか遠くへ行ってしまいそうで目を離せなかったからな。
オカリンの人質になってから少しずつ灰色の世界に色が戻ってきたんだ。オカリン、マユシーを人質にしてくれて、ありがとう。だけど、もうマユシーのことはいいから。
それは、どういう意味だ？
Okarin sharply glares at me and I hesitate to keep talking. But I gather up my courage and desperately go on.
マユシーは、やっぱり、オカリンの重荷になりたくないから。オカリンの優しい嘘にこれ以上甘えてちゃダメだって思うから、いつか変わらなくちゃって思ってたから。だから、
マユリ、何を言ってる。
I take a deep breath and calm my heart. If possible, I don't want to say these words, but I have to.
今日をもってマユシーは、オカリンの人質を、卒業しようと思います。
なんだと?そんなことは認めん。勝手に決めるな。
オカリンは、いっぱいいっぱいマユシーのせいで苦しんできたの。マユシーは知ってる。でもね、マユシーは、オカリンが苦しむのは、もう これ以上見たくないよ。
Take the diary and blue Upa from my bag behind me and hold them out to Okarin. You maybe wanted to put an I before that sentence started.
これ、オカリンに持っててもらいたいんだ。マユシーの代わりに。
ウーパと日記帳？
青ウーパはね、マユシーのウーパコレクションの中で一番お気に入りの子で、マユシーの宝物なんだ。
宝物なら自分で持っておけばいいだろう。
一番大事なものだからオカリンに持っててほしいの。ほら、青ウーパは水色だからマユシーのお気に入りのお洋服と同じ色だし、青ウーパを見るたびにマユシーのことも思い出してくれたら嬉しいなーって。
変なことを言うな。俺がお前を忘れるはずがないだろう。青ウーパなんぞの手を借りる必要はない。
そんなこと言わないでね、オカリン。マユシーの日記帳と青ウーパをね、マユシーの代わりに人質にしてあげて。
Okarin tries to hand the diary and blue Upa back to me, but I step back. With this, there's nothing left, and I have no regrets. All I need to do is press the send button on the message I prepared beforehand. Oh, that's right. Yeah, the D-mail is set. My thumb hovers over the send button on my cell phone behind my back. This D-mail is the door to a past where I never became Okarin's hostage. Oh no. That's not right. A message to fulfill the promise I broke with Grandma that day. A message that I'll send to my mom's cell phone in the past.
Mayuri? What are you doing? Oh,
Masaka! Okari! Mata itsuka aou ne! Kitto aeru yo ne!
When Okarin notices me holding my cell phone behind my back, he grabs onto me.
D-mail! Mayuri! Yamero! Yameru nda!
He's really strong. He grips my wrist and tries to get the phone out of my hand.
Okarin! Mata ne!
I try my hardest to smile, but I'm frustrated that no matter how hard I try, it's a crying smile at best.
Mayushi は本当はずっとオカリンの痛かったよ。
Right before I'm about to drop the phone, I press the send button. The next moment, everything around me goes quiet. It's so quiet, my ears hurt. Okarin's saying something, but I can't hear anymore. I don't know what he's saying. It's the same as back when Grandma died. In the span of a moment, the world is painted completely gray. Uh-oh. What the fuck? What the dickens happened? Well, who knows? Alright, well, we'll figure out what happens next time. Haha. Yeah, that was kind of surprising. Wow. You know, I remembered in the back of my head, I'm like, oh yeah, she did ask Daru about the whole D-mail thing, like prepare it for whatever time. So he must have. And she timed it right. She had a message, I guess, prepared. And, well, I wasn't really expecting that type of message. Wow. Alright. That'll change things. So I wonder what's happening now. And there's, I guess we'll find out next time, you know? Thank you all for watching this episode. If you enjoyed, be sure to leave a like, subscribe, all that fancy shit, and I'll see you guys in the next one. Take it easy.